Bum-ba-da-dum! Howdy, welcome to BanjoBenClark.com. I'm Banjo Ben, your host here on the website to teach you how to play banjo, mandolin. This week is guitar. Now, years ago, I did a really advanced version of Salt Creek. It was really popular, but I've had lots of requests to go back and teach more of the basic melody, especially in this newer format where we have the tabs on the screen and all that. So that's what we're going to do here. We're going to cover the bare bones of Salt Creek. We are going to talk about kind of how to beef it up a little bit, and then we're also going to spend some time on how to play the rhythm and cover the chords in this song, because some people can get confused. So if you're looking to learn the tune Salt Creek, this is where you need to be. Now, if you're watching on Facebook or YouTube, here in a moment, I'll ask you to come over to my website, BanjoBenClark.com. You can come over there, join as a Gold Peak member, have access to hundreds of lessons, lots of fiddle tunes just like this one, and much, much more. I'd be honored to have you on board. Let's jump right into Salt Creek, even though it's in the dead of winter. Let's learn a melody solo for Salt Creek. What do I mean by melody solo? Well, I mean we're going to leave a lot of the frills and thrills to the side for now, and I have an advanced version of this on the side. But we want to boil it down to what is the main melody of this great old fiddle tune, because we need to know that if we're going to improvise on it later on. So let's do that. Now, this one's in the key of A, and so I'm going to play out a G position but capo up on the second fret. So if we capo second fret and then play G position, G chord, we're now in the key of A. And if you're playing this with fiddle players and mandolin players, they're going to want to play it in the key of A. Well, banjo players, y'all can both agree to do it without a capo, and it's fine in the key of G. All right, so this is a standard fiddle tune. It has that very familiar fiddle tune structure that many of them have, where we have an A part that's 8 measures long, then we repeat it, and then go to a B part that has a different melody, slightly different chord progression, and repeat it. So we have a total of 32 measures for one solo. So we're going to learn a basic A part, and then change it up just a little bit just to show you a different way to play it. And then the same for the two B parts as well. Let's go ahead and throw up this first line of tab there. And we're going to walk into this first A part just with some quarter note pickup. Right there. Now I want you to notice that I have little black arrows beneath each one of these notes. Those are our pick stroke directions. I want you to pay attention to those, especially if you're just starting to flat pick, because our down arrow is going to happen on our down beats. 1, 2, 3, 4. And the up arrow is going to happen on our up. 1, 2, 3, 4. And it's important to keep that going and keep that rhythm, that pace going. And you'll also notice our chords above the measures. Those are written as if we don't have a capo on, you know. So we're playing a G chord here in measure 3, even though it's really an A chord because we do have the capo. All right, so as we walk up there and we get to that first measure of the melody that happens there in measure 3, we're going to go into this fiddle rhythm, kind of a shuffle rhythm here. That's kind of what a fiddle likes to do, right? So we're going to do a measure full of that and then walk up measure 4 for a brief stint over a C chord. Now, if I was just going to boil that down to what is the straight up melody and play it in quarter notes, it would sound like this, measures 3 and 4. Boom, 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 boom. That's the melody. And if we're going to kind of fill that in with a few eighth notes, that's what we have here. Now, when you hit that first fret up there, leave that down as we go into measure 5. And then I want you to play a partial F chord, and that's what we're doing. We're going over an F chord, and that's one thing that makes Salt Creek unique, along with a few other fiddle tunes. They go to this F chord, this dominant seventh chord, and it brings in this very blues-sounding attitude. And so we're going to go measure 5, and we're going to play over that F major chord. Sounds like this. And I like for you to leave the first and the ring finger down. That helps with our overtones so that we're not ringing out a bunch of open strings. Now, let me play this first line for you. We'll play it much slower later on. It sounds like this. So I've left that first finger down. That just helps with the overall sound. As we go into the next line, we're going to have a little repeat. And then we're going to wrap up this first A part. And in measure 9, we've got a melodic lick over this F chord again. And we can almost treat this like a D lick. But I would advise you to try to leave the F sharps out of it. It's especially when you're playing it fast, people do it all the time and it sounds okay. But if we play instead of an F sharp, play that F to go along with the chord, it will help it sound a little smoother. Just a great little melodic lick. The whole line. play the next A part, and there's going to be a lot of things in common, of course, because it's the same melody, same chord progression. We are going to add in one slide. If you've never done these slides before, this is a good one to learn. So we're going to start there with our ring finger on the third fret and slide into this melody note by sliding 3 to 5. There's our melody note there. It matches the open third string. So it sounds like this. Then the same lick almost. We're adding 1/8 note in. So you can compare measure 12 to measure 4. And then when we go to this F chord, we're going to get a bit more melodic. Earlier we went. We're going to change it up a little bit and work just kind of an F lick and work it in a repetitive fashion that sounds really cool. 13 and 14 sounds like this. So we're just going down the scale and back up. And I'm going to keep that first fret down up here with this one as well. This whole line. Sounds pretty cool, doesn't it? Measure 15. Same thing here. And then we're going to do another melodic F lick here, measure 17. It's going to be a bit different than measure 9, though. We're just going to change the order of the notes a little bit. Starting with the last notes in 16, we're going to lead up starting on our third fret. I want you to notice something here in 17 and 18. In 17 we have a measure of F, so I'm going to play the F naturals, not the F sharps. So kind of treat it as a blues D lick. But when we go into 18, we're going to have a half measure of D, and then I'm going to change that F sharp from F natural to F sharp just to kind of accentuate the chord change. I could play in measure 18, play that third fret over that D chord, and it would sound fine. It would make it more bluesy sounding. But by doing an F natural up here and then switching to an F sharp down here, you're working along with the backup rhythm. The whole line. Good stuff. Let's look at the B parts now.